What's up? Welcome to another Whipping with Wisdom.
Whipping with Wisdom.
Whipping with Wisdom.
That's a kind of a tongue twister. Whipping
Wisdom with Pat.
Dude, I can't say it. Whipping with wisdom.
So Kyle, where are we going?
We are on our way to, you know, it's gold, great golden arches.
McDonald's.
I'm not gonna lie, I thought we were going to Golden Corral. I was really excited.
Dude, no. We're going to McDonald's. Healthiest food joint around.
Golden Corral is not good.
It's so delicious down south. I would like to try it.
Yeah, down south is probably amazing, but here they don't care about it. They do not care about food quality.
That is sad.
Well, while we head in the direction of the Golden Arches.
True.
This is Proverbs 25:7-9. Oh. So it says, what you have seen with your eyes, do not bring hastily to court.
Can you read it? I'm sorry, the title is
so blurry. For what will you do in the end if your neighbor puts you to shame? If you take your neighbor to court, do not betray another's confidence.
Oh.
That was maybe a little carsick trying to read that. Not gonna lie.
Yeah, I took a picture of it and it, for some reason, came out really blurry.
So, my first question is, what, for both of you guys, what's the first thing that you do when somebody wrongs you? What do you typically do?
It goes a lot of different ways. It depends on like what it is, but most of the time, I'll try my hardest to just talk to that person about it, you know? Sometimes if it's like, depending on what it is, sometimes I'll talk to my friends first about it, but I try to talk to that person about it first.
Yeah. I mean, it just depends for me, man. Like, it can go to like the lowest offense, or it's just like, I mean, like if it ain't nothing too bad, then I'll just keep it above 50 with myself, just be like, look, just don't even sweat it. But if it's like pretty, like it's pretty rough, I might have like my boys that I might talk to. We got some friends, some people that I trust. And just have to like vent out my heart a little bit, because you know sometimes people be taking to that extra place, and you just sometimes you be about ready to pop off, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like you about ready to show somebody the other side, a different side, the non-pastoral Christian side. And so sometimes you just need to vent out some frustrations before you go all
Jackie Chan on there.
All Jackie Chan on somebody.
So, real quick, I mean you brought up talking to your friends.
Yeah.
When you're upset with somebody else.
Mm-hmm.
Is it wrong to talk to somebody about an issue that you're having with someone else?
No.
You know what I mean?
It depends on how you do it though. Because there's so many different ways to go about that. Because like what we're saying, we're talking to our friends in confidence and letting them know like, hey, this is on my heart. This is what's bothering me. But there's a complete other side to that where you could also just be like, hey, yo, this guy did this. This guy's awful. Don't talk to this guy. He's this, he's that, he's this, he's that. It could even go as far as posting on social media, doing all that stuff, starting rumors. That's how rumors get started, actually, in the first place. You talk smack about one person because he did something, he wronged you in this way, and then that person goes and shares that with another person. This guy's that.
Subtweeting.
Posting on Instagram. I don't know if people ever actually post on Instagram. Like, this guy sucks, but I know a lot of it happens on Twitter. I don't know a lot of you guys are on Twitter, but yeah, there's different ways to do it, and there's a right way and there's a wrong way.
Yeah, I think that you talk to your friends it's not fake, it's how you go about it. So, like, if you guys are talking for confidence and talking for your friends just to get some good advice, like, hey, how should I address the situation? I don't think that's bad, but when you turn your friends into a mob, or y'all start being subliminal with the hits, like social media hits, and y'all just talking about each other, but you're not man enough or woman enough to say it to the person's face, that's when it's an issue, because that's fake.
Mm-hmm.
mm-hmm. and nobody got time for fakeness. Like, no, you know, like if you got, if you gonna keep it a buck 50 with someone, you just tell it in a godly way or a kind way, but you just tell them like straight up, like, we have a problem and I'd like to fix it. Mm-hmm. Don't be like, you know, adding or hashtagging somebody or trying to spill tea or trying to be a Karen out here in these streets. Like,
you don't want to be a Karen. You don't want to be calling for the manager.
You don't want to be a Karen.
You don't want to be no Karen. Don't be no Bobby, Thomas, Johnny. You know,
if your name is Karen,
we're not talking about you.
Yeah, we're not talking about that.
Hopefully,
unless you being a Karen out here, the Karen, this is all about you. But not like on the real. Like, you know, if you take your problems in social media and have social media beef, then like, how old are you? Like,
yeah,
like that's. Like, a grown adult struggle with this, man. Like, I mean, we're all in our 20s, and, like, I can tell you the times that I've...
Oh, I've seen so many subtweets of people.
I'm just like, yo, how are we subtweeting, like, in our 20s, man?
You're
like,
an adult.
An adult. Like, it's embarrassing. Like...
It is.
You got a problem with somebody, use your words. They teach you that. Like, use your words. Mm-hmm. And so for those who, like, who are thinking, like, well, I'm bold, I'll say what I need to say, then, you know... You need to talk to your friends to get advice. Get advice, but keep it between y'all. Like, exactly, I think that's what that whole bite, that first means, that you take them to court. Like, if you want to put that into, like, relative terms now, and you decide to talk to them, you know, don't spill their confidence. Don't
you have to
tell all, everybody no, yeah. about their business, and don't be fake about it to where everybody else knows what they did. Like, yep. if it's an issue between one and two, it needs to say an issue between one and two. Don't add three, four, and five to the situation.
You know that your friend's gonna be not necessarily on your side, but yeah, on your side, because you're coming to them and they're your friends. You're just asking for advice. What you don't want to do is basically say, hey, dude, this guy did this.
Uh-huh.
Let's go do this together and like team up on him. You don't want to do that, because you're bringing other people into this issue that don't need to be in the issue.
And then you lose place, man. Like, you lose. Like, any right of you being done wrong is automatically taken out when you're the one that's doing wrong to someone else.
Exactly.
Like, you know, if you are the one who got done ugly, then be the only one that remains to be the one who got done ugly. Like, don't do ugly to someone else,
yeah.
too.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Too ugly don't make it pretty. Ain't how that works.
Two uglies don't make a pretty.
Also, Kyle, bro, you drive terribly, bro. We've been driving here for forever, and I still ain't seen no McDonald's.
It's far, bro. They're far.
We're going to the one in Brandy. What?
No. The one all the way in Calvert, bro.
The what?
Calvert County? No.
They know. Oh, turn the music up, bro. Turn the music up, bro. I ain't trying to drive like this.
Well, we're almost there. We love you guys.
We love you.
Remember,
food.
We'll get food soon. Don't jump into things and be a Karen.
Don't be a Karen.
Don't be a Karen. But also, don't be a Kyle and drive.
Don't be a Kyle the way I drive. No, you don't want to see that.
Don't put people on blast.
Don't put people on blast. All
right, guys. We love you. We'll see you on the next Whipping with Wisdom.
Bye. I'm hungry.
Oh, that sounds so good.
Are we there yet?